The year is 2005. Minutes after an epic face-off between American teenager Freddy Adu,
hey, I'm Freddy,
and Argentine Lionel Messi. Billed as the battle of two wonder kids of their generation, the fateful meeting was at the 2005 FIFA World Youth Championship, where Adu was remarkably considered superior to the Barca youngling despite being 2 years younger. Adu's dominant skill and desire was noticeable, and Messi, who didn't play the first half, needed to catch up. In a nearly sold-out stadium, at the 39th minute, the U.S. found itself on top of the South American Giants with a 1-0 scoreline. And at the time, the hype for the Maryland native seemed deserved. At just 13 years old, he signed a lucrative contract with Nike. At 14, he scored 4 goals during the 2003 FIFA U17 World Championship. And after he was selected by DC United in the 2004 MLS Super Draft, he became the youngest athlete ever to sign a professional contract in the United States. By 16, he tallied 11 goals and 17 assists during his first 2 seasons in MLS. He was a household name in the States by this point and had transcended the American mainstream, a feat for any soccer player to pull off at the time. Meanwhile, 4,000 miles away in Spain, Messi's star was just beginning to supernova. Already a wonder kid for boyhood club Newell's Old Boys in his native Argentina, his career faced a difficult disruption after he was diagnosed with growth hormone deficiency at 10 years old. Unable to continue payments for the treatments, his family managed to move to Barcelona's La Masia Youth Academy and secured financial help for his treatments from the club. At 14, Messi finally completed the treatment and during his first full season with the youth side, became their top scorer with 36 goals in 30 games. He also became an integral part of the Baby Dream Team alongside Cesc Fabregas and Gerard Piqué. At 16 years old, Messi made his first team debut when he came on during a friendly against Jose Mourinho's Porto. Then, when he made his official debut at 17, he set a record debuting for 5 Barcelona squads in a single campaign. In the 3 years before that fateful matchup, the teenager's ability, raw talent, and bright futures had people speaking about them in the same breath. Before Messi became the measuring stick of greatness in soccer, it was Pelé, and having Adu compared to him was no small accomplishment. In a big soccer forum post, fans were hopeful and jubilant about the possibility of the next Pelé coming from America. The simulation game Football Manager even gave Adu a slightly better rating than Messi, and even FIFA had them on a similar playing field. While Messi's name recognition was slowly growing during that time, it was Adu who was expected to enjoy the better career. But the end of that match in 2005 marked the point where the two players' trajectory changed forever. While the U.S. claimed a remarkable victory and a respectable run into the round of 16, at the end of the tournament, Messi had officially arrived on the international scene. He not only went on to win the tournament with Argentina, but also the Golden Boot with 6 goals. Meanwhile, Adu scored no goals throughout the tournament and went back home empty-handed where his missed opportunities were not going unnoticed. After failing to live up to expectations at DC United, his career as a journeyman began. Adu was eventually traded to Real Salt Lake, then Benfica, and even had a 2-week trial with Manchester United. Since then, he's gone on to play for 13 teams in 8 different countries, including Portugal, France, Turkey, Brazil, Serbia, and Finland. And in an ironic twist, 10 years after he first faced off with Messi, he got a chance to play with another one. During his stint in Brazil, Messi's first cousins Maxi and Emmanuel Biancucci signed for Bahia, Adu's 9th team. With every new team and country, Adu's youth and talent held up less and less, and his once bright prospects faded away. He resurfaced again in 2017, looking to jumpstart his career once again with 2nd Division USL side Las Vegas Lights. Messi, on the other hand, went on to win countless trophies with Barcelona, represent his country at the top level, and change soccer history forever. In the US, we have a knack for hyping young stars like Landon Donovan and Julian Green, and it happens all too often. Reflecting on his career in an interview, Adu stated, "It was a lot of pressure. It really was. As a 14, 15, 16-year-old, you're young. You're immature, you kind of get caught up in that a little bit." And it seems like history is repeating itself once again with current U.S. men's national team starlet Christian Pulisic. "I would say that the expectation some Americans put on me is too much," he said in an interview with ESPN. "I know no one means harm to me or wants to put too much pressure on me. It's kind of what they've done or do in the past. So next time you want to call Christian Pulisic the American Messi, think of Adu as a cautionary tale."